Hi, I'm Stefan.
And we are going to show you how to assemble a nipple column for protein purification. So the first thing you need is the empty plastic column. So there you go, you can put that into the clamp. And then put the cap on the bottom. And the first thing you have to do is fill it up with buffer. So we have a beaker of buffer right here, so just fill it all the way up. We're going to add this little frit into the bottom, and that's what's going to hold the nipple resin into the plastic column. But before you put it in there, you need to make sure that it's wet and that there's no air underneath it. So that's why you have to fill buffer all the way up to the top. So you can drop it in there and let it kind of soak the buffer up. And you'll use the back of a pipette to push it down to the bottom. And it's a little tricky because sometimes it gets kind of stuck in there at an angle, and then it's hard to jam it all the way down. And it's okay if you get a little air bubble stuck under there. You just don't want it to be all air underneath, or you'll get a lot of back pressure, and it'll take forever for your column to run. All right, so once the frit's down, you can take the cap off and just run that buffer down. And then the next step is gonna be adding the nipple resin. So I have some in a tube here. And nickel can be kind of hard to work with. These are tiny agarose beads suspended in liquid, and they settle down to the bottom of the tube. So your TAs will probably be kind of handling this, but you just want to make sure that it's really well mixed before you try to pipette it, or else you'll end up just pipetting buffer off the top and not getting any of the nipple resin. So I'll let you do it. You're going to put a mill of that into the column. And I like to do it with the cap off. But if you do it that way, you want to make sure you add buffer immediately on top so that it doesn't get dried out. Yeah, there you can see you got a nice glob of nickel resin, which is okay. And then we just have to kind of let it run down so that the nickel gets settled there above the frit. And once it looks like most of it is settled, the next step is going to be adding a little bit of glass wool on top of the nickel. And this is to kind of filter out any kind of particulate junk that might still be in your sample so that it doesn't clog up the resin. And this can be a little bit tricky because sometimes people want to put like a whole handful of glass resin and jam it down in there, which just slows up the column. So you only need a little bit, a little pinch, so that when you ball it up, it's enough to kind of cover the width of the column. So I would say with a pipette, kind of gently add more buffer to the top of this as it's running. So now we want to fill it up again to the top so that we can put the glass wool on top and kind of soak up the buffer just like we did with the frit. And now you need to be careful when you're pipetting, when you're putting buffer in, that you don't kind of mix up the resin that we just settled in the bottom. So then after this, you can probably put the cap on, so you can do the glass wool. So you're just gonna drop that in the top. And the kind of tricky thing here, again, is that you don't want to have air bubbles trapped under or within the glass wool. So usually, you know, I'll take the thin end of the pasture pipette and just kind of swirl it around and kind of squeeze out any air bubbles that might be stuck in there. And then you're going to slide the glass wool down so that it's, you want a little space between the top of the resin and the bottom of the glass wool. Yep, perfect, right there. All right, so at this point, it's pretty much assembled. We just want to rinse the resin a little bit more. So you want to wash it with 5 column volumes of buffer. And since we put 1 mil of resin onto the column, it's a 1 mil column. So you're going to run 5 mils over. We probably already have 3 or 4 mils on there. So maybe you would just add 1 or 2 more mils to rinse the column. And then once you get the 5 mils or whatever through, we run it down so that the level of the liquid is just above the top of the glass wool. So we'll just pretend we ran 5 mils through, and we'll let it run to about the right spot. Okay, so now our column is ready, and your next step would be to take the centrifuge cell lysate and run it over the column. And as you do that, you want to collect the flow through, so you can take an empty, clean Falcon tube like Stefan has, and just put it underneath your column, so you might have to lift your column up a little. So you would just take the cap off and load as much volume as you can, and you'll probably have to keep loading volume until you get it all run through. Collect it here, and then again you'll cap it right before the liquid runs into the glass bowl. And then the next steps are to wash and dilute, and for those steps you collect fractions. So what you'll want to do is have your tubes labeled and kind of arranged in a rack like this. And then you can collect 1 or 1.5 mil fractions, whatever you need, by just kind of sliding the rack underneath. So you'll fill a mill, and then you can just slide it to the next tube. And that's it.